Let's go through some breaking news this afternoon to kick off things. Political editor Andrew Clennell joins me. Andrew, what's the latest? You've got some breaking news in relation to the New South Wales lockdown and the outbreak.
That's right, Kieran. Sky News can reveal that there is likely to be an end to the statewide lockdown in New South Wales announced tomorrow or Friday, with restrictions around some areas eased. The decision on which areas will be lifted from lockdown will be taken around three factors: case numbers in each area, proximity to local government areas with case numbers if you don't have any, and sewage testing. It will mean people back to work and kids back to school in certain areas. So as well as Premier Gladys Berejiklian's big announcement expected that there will be one freedom, such as vaccinated hairdressing in non-hotspot local government areas that reopens, there will be an easing of restrictions in a few parts of the state. So think the North Coast, Riverina, Wallandilly and Southern Highlands. They're likely areas in which the lockdown will be eased on Saturday. In terms of the rest of the state, it's quite clear there are areas the government will not be opening for weeks.
As you can see in the numbers today, the Central West isn't getting better, the Far West isn't getting better. The Hunter New England, even though under control, still has cases amongst a number of local government areas. In the Central Coast, the Illawarra, Shoalhaven, Wollongong again, the highest number of cases in this outbreak. Shoal Harbour, we've got the issue in Canberra yesterday posting its highest level of infections in Canberra, which does put pressure on the southern New South Wales. And this morning already, sewage surveillance showing that in Murrimbula, high case of surveillance. So in one way, you've got to manage all of that. And the reality, this is about protecting lives and making sure we don't lose control in regional and rural New South Wales.
The crisis New South Wales Cabinet meeting to decide all this is happening now. In some ways, to open up some areas in large parts of the state is a no-brainer. No COVID in an area, get it open. There's nothing to stop you shutting it again quickly if COVID cases arise.